Welcome to iLaunch 2010. This is a very special occasion, and I want to welcome over 300 members of the IFX class of 2014 to what should be a very special event. In welcoming you, I want to recount that these activities began over 3 years ago as a grassroots effort to help transform engineering education at the University of Illinois. And those grassroots efforts turned into a college activity in the fall of 2008, only 2 years ago. And the first freshman experience began just last year. So welcome, and IFX is designed as a joyful way to begin your engineering education here at the University of Illinois. Now, I'd like you to take a moment and introduce yourself to the person on the left and the person on the right of you. State your name and where you're from. And then I want you to discuss the answers to two questions with those people. Why did you choose to come to engineering school and to be an engineer? And why did you choose to join IFX? So why don't we take a moment to do that? And our hope in doing this is to explore engineering, this community we're in, and the learning that we're going to do here at the University of Illinois. Now, we'll come back to the discussions that you've had with your the person on your left and your right in a moment. But what I want to discuss with you this afternoon is a number of things, and we're going to do it in a particular order. First, I'd like to talk about three terms of art. And these terms are important terms that we'll use over and over this year. And we need to define them so we don't get them confused or messed up. Then I want to talk about the joy or joys of engineering. And sometimes those terms are not found in the same sentence, but I think you'll find our discussion interesting. Then talk about the joy of engineering and the aspiration of our IFX class, you the I students. From there, I want to move and talk about, from talking about the joy of engineering to talking about the joy of X. So we're going to enlarge the sense of things that we're joyful about. And that'll lead us to discuss kind of a historical perspective and view the origins of a modern engineering education and the ways in which it needs to change because of the way in which the world has itself changed. We'll then ask the question, what is it that engineers trained in a traditional Cold War engineering education don't know how to do when they have their first engagement in the real world? We'll talk about social connectedness and the I community, and then we'll talk about T-shaped engineers and lifelong learning. So let's start with our three terms of art. One term of art is the term iFoundry. iFoundry is shorthand for the Illinois Foundry for Innovation in Engineering Education, and iFoundry is an organization in the University of Illinois College of Engineering designed to incubate or pilot change in engineering education. It's designed to help transform engineering education from the imperatives of the Cold War coming out of World War II to the imperatives of a creative era in the 21st century. Another term that we'll use is IFX. IFX stands for the Illinois Engineering Freshman Experience, and that's what you're engaged in, that's what you volunteered for. And it's a freshman experience designed to build student confidence, initiative, and engineering identity. And it consists of special course, Introduction to the Missing Basics of Engineering, as well as the iCommunity experiences that iLaunch is a part of. And we'll have more to say about that. And then finally, iCommunity is a community of intrinsically motivated learners and builders here at the University of Illinois. And part of what you've signed up for as part of IFX is to join that community. But the community goes beyond your freshman year and actually involves building a community of intrinsically motivated learners and builders throughout your 4 years. And so we'll use those three terms throughout the semester, throughout the year, and we need to keep them sort of separated and differentiated. Now, let's talk about engineering and the way in which engineering can be a joyful way to spend one's life. Now, I think the first thing to understand there is that engineering is not a monolith. It's not one thing. It's a complex set of skills. It's sometimes a profession. Right now, it's an education. But one thing that engineering is that it's a creative, challenging profession in which people operate in the real world to solve problems in companies, problems in societies, problems for people. And in that sense, it's also a constructive and real world profession. Now, sometimes people come to engineering because they're good in math and science, and they don't think of themselves as people persons. But engineering is a people profession. Engineering is a team sport performed both by and for people. And so it's very much about people working with people and trying to help people. These days, it's a global profession. Projects travel around the world at the speed of light. Projects follow the sun, as it's said. And so there are opportunities to be engaged in your home country or in a foreign land. More and more, engineering is an entrepreneurial way to spend one's life, to start companies and help to bring products and services to fruition that have never existed before. It's also a serving profession. Engineering is a way to help others, as exhibited by things at the University of Illinois like the LINC program and the Engineers Without Borders Club. Moreover, it's an optimistic can-do profession. Engineering is about accomplishing things in the real world and believing that you can affect change in a positive way. Let's highlight one of these in particular and talk about engineering as a creative and challenging profession. The engineer and professor, Theodor von Karman, had a nice way of comparing engineering to science. He said, the scientist merely explores that which exists, while the engineer creates what has never existed before. And that's an essential differentiation, I think, that's important to keep in mind. Science is about understanding. Engineering is about affecting change in the world. So engineering is fundamentally about creating new products, services, and processes and making those work well. That's an intellectual challenge that requires the novel application of knowledge in new and perhaps very challenging circumstances. Now let's talk about the joy of engineering and your aspirations. When we asked the first freshman experience class and this class as to why you wanted to become engineers, we got three different clusters of answers. One type of student told us that they wanted to create cool technology, cool products and services, because they liked to make things work and they were fascinated by how things worked. Another group wanted to be the next Max Levchin, who's pictured there in the slide. They wanted to be the next great tech entrepreneur. And then others told us that they wanted to help others, that they wanted to save the world, to create a more sustainable world and solve societal problems and to do a kind of service. And so we respect and admire all these aspirations, and as a result, the iTeams that have been created and that you've signed up for have been set up to align with your many different aspirations. Now, to get a fuller picture of this, we need to move from the joy of engineering to the joy of X, where X is an element of the set engineering, community, and learning. And to get that, we need to get a little bit of historical perspective and think of the origins of current engineering education in the post-World War II era of the Cold War. And at the time of the Cold War, engineering was performed in fairly large hierarchical organizations, and engineers did specialized work on existing categories of products and services. And so we'll take a look at that, and we'll examine the consequences of that for what is an appropriate engineering education in our times. We'll then talk about what's missing in an engineer's education if you're trained only in that kind of Cold War kind of engineering. And then we'll consider this from the perspective of the joy of engineering, the joy of community, and the joy of learning. So as the movie said, Houston, we've got a problem. After World War II, engineering accepted the notion that science won the war and injected a lot of math and science into the curriculum that had not been there, and removed practical subjects like design that had been there. And so engineering was viewed as primarily scientific and mathematical and fairly individualistic and narrow. Well,